हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। प्रेस द सब्सक्राइब बटन लाइक दिस एंड देन यू हैव टू टैप द बेल आइकन एडजेसेंट टू द सब्सक्राइब बटन लाइक दिस एंड देन यू विल गेट द नोटिफिकेशन फ्रॉम माय चैनल।
हेलो गाइस एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ गियर ट्रेन्स, न्यूमेरिकल्स रिगार्डिंग गियर ट्रेन्स। Now the main method to solve the epicyclic gear train problems, it is the tabular method and algebraic method, but I would be preferring tabular method because it is very simple and you can solve the problems in less time. Now in my previous video I had covered all the types of gear trains, so if you have not watched the theory video of gear trains, you can click on the top right corner I appearing on your screen right now. Now in this video we would be talking only about the numericals regarding the gear trains. Now the basic numericals of epicyclic gear train that can be solved by tabular method and algebraic method, but I would be covering tabular method because it is very easy to understand and there is no mistake or error while solving the problems, while in algebraic method some logic needs to be applied. Now to consider the tabular method, first you see the epicyclic gear train. Here A is one gear, B is one gear, and both the gears A and B, they are connected through an arm. So in all the problems where an arm is given, then you can say that is the epicyclic gear train, and then only you can apply this tabular method. Now let's begin with the method, how you can apply, and then we will be seeing the numericals. Now we will be creating tables like this. If we are having more number of gears, so we will make separate columns for each and every gear. Suppose we are having 5 gears A, B, C, D, so we will make columns gear for gear A, gear B, gear C, gear D, gear E, and arm is always taken on the left side. First column is the arm, then comes the gears, and the table can be of n number of columns depending on the number of gears. Now first step is we fix the arm and we give plus 1 revolution anticlockwise to the next gear, gear A, or the gear attached directly to arm. We give plus 1 revolution, so you write, first you write 0 here in the first step of arm because it is fixed, so revolutions will be 0 because it is fixed, and we give plus 1 revolution to gear that is attached directly to arm C. Here in the above figure you can see that arm C, it is gear A, it is directly connected to arm C, so when we give plus 1 revolution to gear A, so we write plus 1 here. In the next column, gear B, you write minus TA upon TB because gear A was like this and gear B was like this, and we are considering gear A to be rotating anti-clockwise. Now if we take anti-clockwise then we write plus, and if we take clockwise then we write minus. So here we have written plus 1 because we are considering plus 1 revolution anti-clockwise given to gear A and arm C is fixed. So you have to write always, you have to write 0 here and you have to write plus 1 here. And the next gear, since gear, this is gear A, it is rotating anticlockwise, so gear B, it will be rotating clockwise, so we would be writing minus convention, minus times TA upon TB, the number of teeth on the previous gear upon the number of teeth on the gear for which we have to write. Alright, minus TA, that is the previous column gear, upon TB for which we are writing. Now in the next line you multiply all these values by x. So here it will be 0 multiplied by x, it will be 0, here plus 1 multiplied by x plus x, here minus TA upon TB into x. Now you add plus y, so 0 plus y will be plus y. No need to write this column, sorry, no need to write this row, you can write directly 0 plus y equal to plus y plus x equal to x plus y and minus x t upon t b plus y, or you can write y minus x t upon t b. So the total motion, these three equations will be formed. Now understand by taking a numerical. I will be covering all the numericals that can be possible. And the first numerical is again the basic problem. This is gear A, this is gear B, both are connected with arm C. So we would be creating a table. Now table, the first column, this you may write or you may not write this thing, but we need three columns because we are having one arm, this is always there, and these columns depend on number of gears. Here there are two gears A and B, so we write gear A and gear B separate columns. And left hand side of this column, that is the first column, it will be always of arm. The next column will be of the gear that is directly mounted on that arm. Here it is gear A. Next will be gear B. If gear C, D, E have been there, so we have to write in separate columns. In the upcoming problems, in the next problem, there will be more gears. So let's understand this problem first. Now arm C, it is fixed, so 0 you write here. Gear A, you give plus 1 anticlockwise motion, so you write plus 1. Gear B, it is minus TA, previous column, upon for which you have to write. So minus TA upon TB. Because this is rotating anticlockwise, and we have taken convention plus as anticlockwise and minus as clockwise. So this is gear A, it is rotating anticlockwise and it is directly connected to B. So when gear A is rotated anticlockwise, so B will be rotated clockwise. So we have taken plus for clockwise, sorry, plus for anticlockwise and minus for clockwise. So here we have written minus TA upon TB. You multiply throughout by X, you add Y, so final we get Y X plus Y, Y minus X TA upon TB. Now these three equations, they are formed. Now in the question, always they will be giving some values. Like if the arm rotates at 150 rpm in anticlockwise, that is the rpm of arm, that is rpm of C, it is given as plus 150. Alright, and we have to find the speed of gear B, we have to find N of B. And if the gear A, instead of being fixed, makes 300 rpm, that is minus 300 rpm, then what is the value of NB? So they are two questions separately. Now first part, it is taken by considering that is the arm rotates at 150, we have to find the speed of gear B. When the gear A is fixed, we have to find the speed of gear B. So we will be taking these equations. We have been given the speed of arm as 150 anticlockwise, because plus 150 because we have taken anticlockwise sign as plus. So 150 is equal to speed of arm C. What we get in the final? Plus Y. So plus Y equal to 150, or Y is equal to 150. And you know that gear A is fixed, so X plus Y equal to 0. Fixed means no motion. So X plus Y equal to 0. From these two equations you calculate value of X and Y. So X comes out to be minus 150. Now what we have to find? We have to find the RPM of gear B. This we have to find. So we have to find ultimately Y minus X TA upon TB. So Y we know 150, and minus X times, that is minus 150 into TA upon TB. Now TA and TB, they are always given in the question. So let us see what is the value of TA and TB. Two gear trains A and B having 36 and 45 teeth respectively. So TA equal to 36, TB equal to 45. Now you substitute here into 36 upon 45. You solve these, you will get plus 270 RPM. So this is our answer, that when gear A is fixed, the speed of gear B is 270 anti-clockwise, because we have taken plus as anti-clockwise. And next part, when this find the speed of gear B when the gear A 300 RPM clockwise. So NA equal to 300 clockwise, that is minus 300, equal to, see from this table, what is gear A? We have given the speed of gear A as 300. So x plus y equal to x plus y. This is the first equation. Alright. X plus y equal to minus 300. Now, y we already know that it is 150 RPM plus 150 RPM because it is anti-clockwise. You substitute here, you find the value of x is equal to minus 450 RPM. Now again, speed of gear B will be y minus x into 36 upon 45. You substitute the value of y and x along with the sign. So 150 minus x will be minus 450 into 36 upon 45. You solve it, you will get plus 510 RPM, or you can say the speed of gear B is 510 RPM anti-clockwise when the gear A makes 300 RPM clockwise. You can write the answer as like this. So this is the first problem. Now let's move to second problem. Now let's take another example of a reverted epicyclic gear train. Now here we are having one arm A, driver gear this is B, and D and E these are compound gears, and finally driven gear it is gear C. And by reading the question, we have to find the gear speed and direction of gear C, that is the driven gear, when gear B or the driving gear is fixed and the arm A makes 100 RPM clockwise or minus 100 RPM. So we would be proceeding by tabular method. Now in the tabular method we know that we require the values of teeth. Now here by reading the question we can see that the number of teeth on gear B, C, D are given, but the number of teeth on gear E they are not given. So first we need to find the teeth on the gear E. How we can find? By looking at the geometry, and this is a typical property of a reverted gear train, that you can see that the arm, that is the axis, these are coaxial or they are parallel, and the axis of B and C they are coaxial, and these two axes they are parallel. So we can apply, that is radius C plus radius E, that is this distance, is equal to radius of B, that is this much, plus radius of E, this much, because this distance is same. So B plus E is equal to C plus D. Alright. So we can write R B plus R E is equal to R C plus R D. And we know that since M into T by 2, this is the radius, so we can substitute the value of R equal to MT by 2, you write here m p by 2 plus so on. We know that module is same, because if it is different, so it is given in the question but it has not mentioned, so we are assuming the module to be same. So m by 2 gets cancelled throughout, so what we are left is tb plus te is equal to tc plus td, and we know the value of tb, tc and td, so we can find value of te. TE equal to 45. Substitute TC plus TD, that is 30 plus 90 minus 75 is 45. So we have found the value of TE. Now let's make the table. Now here the table consists of 4 columns. Now the compound here we have to take it as a single column. Always. Alright. First column is arm. Second column is compound gear DE. Third column is gear B and fourth column is gear C. This is arm A. On this, read the question that find the speed and direction of gear C, that is the driven gear, when the gear B is fixed and the arm A makes 100 rpm clockwise. Now arm A, it makes 100 rpm clockwise, and on arm A they are mounted compound gear D and E and also gear B. So let us assume that arm A, first it is fixed, this is always 0, and we give plus 1 counterclockwise rotation to compound gear D and E, so gear B will be equal to minus TE upon TB. How I have written minus TE upon TB? Because you see, gear B, it is directly connected to gear E. So we have to write previous one upon the one for which we are writing. So it will be TE upon TB. Now why I have to put minus? Because if E is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, that is positive, so B will rotate clockwise, that is negative. So negative sign comes and minus TE upon TB comes here. And for gear C, it would be minus TB upon TC. Why? Because this gear C, it meshes with gear D. Here you can see dotted. That is, when you see from the top view or you see from the back view, you can see these two gear meshing. So we would be writing first gear D, then we write for which we have to find. So we would be writing TD upon TC. And again we put minus sign because it is rotating in the opposite direction, so minus sign. Now we have written in the first row, we have completed. Now we multiply throughout by x and then we add y plus y. So finally we get plus y x plus y minus x t upon tb and y minus x td upon tc. Now from the question we know that gear B is fixed. Now gear B is fixed, that means this value y minus x t upon tb is 0. So we know value of TE, TB, so we get y minus 0.6x is equal to 0. Also we know that arm A makes 100 rpm clockwise, that is plus y, it is given as minus 100, because clockwise we take negative sign. So y is equal to minus 100 rpm. Now you substitute the value of here, y here, so you get the value of x as minus 166.67 rpm. that is 166.67 RPM clockwise, that is X. Now we have to find the value of C, that is the RPM of C. So RPM of C will be Y minus X TD upon TC. Now TD value is TD upon TC, 90 upon 30. 90 upon 30. So this gets cancelled 3 times. So finally we have to find Y minus 3X. Y minus 3X. We know the value of Y as minus 100 minus 3 times X. X is minus 166.67. We substitute and find the value. Finally we get the value of C as plus 400 RPM. So plus 400 RPM or 400 RPM anti-clockwise. That is the speed of gear C, and the direction is anti-clockwise because we are getting plus 7. Alright, so this is the reverted gear train. Now comes the sun and planet gear train problem. Now this is the third type of problem that we can get. Now in the sun and planet gear, what is there? You understand that there is a sun and a planet. Now we know that sun is in the center of the solar system, and earth or the planets, they rotate or sorry they revolve and complete the revolution around the sun. Similarly here a gear system is there in which this E, this is the sun, and this gear B, this is the planet. So it rotates, it completes the revolution around. If such type of problem is there, then we can proceed similarly. How we can do? Suppose this is given, this is the question. Epicyclic gear train of 3 gears is given in as shown in figure 13.10. This is 13.10. We have been given the number of gears as gear A, it has 72 teeth, gear C 32 teeth, gear B meshes with both A and C, that is gear B it meshes both with gear A, that is the outer gear, it meshes here, and gear C, that is it meshes here. And what we are given? We are given an arm that is rotated at 18 rpm. Now 18 rpm or plus 18 rpm, that is the speed of the arm EF. The speed of the arm EF is given as 18 rpm anti-clockwise or plus 18 rpm. Now if the gear A is fixed, that is if NA it is 0, we have to find the speed of gear B and C. We have to find the speed of gear B and C. Again we construct the tables. Now, first is the arm EF, second comes the gear C. Now see the diagram first. First we always write arm. Now here arm is EF, you write EF. Then on which it is attached, first gear it is C, you write C. Then you write gear A, then you write gear B because after C it is B, and then finally you write gear A. Now we have to fill the table. Now first you know always it is 0, then plus 1, now it is minus TC upon TP. Why? Because when gear C it is rotated plus 1 anti-clockwise, that is gear C is rotated plus 1 anti-clockwise, so gear B will rotate clockwise, so minus comes, minus sign comes, and we have to write RPM for B. So we will write TC upon, for which we have to find, that is the B, so TB minus TC upon TB. And for A similarly, this is rotating clockwise, so this is rotating anti-clockwise. So we will write minus TC upon TB for A. For gate A, we will be writing with respect to C. Now, since this was rotating anti-clockwise, this was rotating clockwise, this was rotating anti-clockwise. Now, with respect to C, we will write minus TC upon TA. Alright. Now, again, we multiply with X throughout. Again we add y, so it will be final plus y x plus y minus x tc upon tb y minus x tc upon ta. Now we are given in the question that the speed of arm, it is 18, that is y value is given as 18. Y value is given as 18 and gear A is fixed, that means gear A, that is y minus x into tc upon ta. TC, that is 32 upon TA, that is 72, it is equal to 0 and Y is equal to 18. These two equations are there given. You put 18 here, Y equal to 18 here, you find the value of X. We get the value of X as 40.5. X is equal to 40.5 RPM plus, that is 40.5 RPM anti-clockwise, and we have to find the speed of gear B and gear C. We have to find the speed of gear B and gear C. Now gear B, it is Y minus X TC upon TB, so you substitute the values, and gear C, it is X plus Y, again you substitute, you will be getting the required answers. As speed of gear C is 58.5 RPM, that is anticlockwise, and speed of gear B, it is 46.8 RPM anticlockwise. So we have solved all three types of numericals related to epicyclic gear train. And if you found the video helpful, please press the like button, please share my video on social media, and please subscribe if you already not subscribed. Please check the description once for more of my social media links and other video links. And please press the like button. And I will be seeing the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.